Big Bend Ranch State Park in West Texas, 265,000 acres of Chihuahuan desert, a landscape that seems to defy the very existence of life. The plants and animals that do live here have to fight for their existence. Over time, these inhabitants have become almost as hard as the country that surrounds them. One resident of this rugged terrain is the elusive mountain lion. In 1992, the Texas Parks and Wildlife Department launched a study of the mountain lions within Big Bend Ranch. The overall goal was to add to the body of knowledge concerning these predators, to determine the home ranges of the adult lions, to learn the survival rate of the young, and evaluate the overall health of the population. Through this study, wildlife personnel would gain first-hand experience in mountain lion ecology.
The Big Canyon, he's got that great big rock pile in it, but you remember we found that scat just on the other
The first step is to locate the cats. For the most part, this means walking for miles into the rugged backcountry, looking for evidence of their passing.
Doing survey work on mountain lions, you're not looking for the lion itself because they're very seldom seen, very rarely seen in the wild. You're looking for tracks. You're looking for scat. You're looking for the scrapes that the males leave. And this stuff is predictable where you can find it after, if you've got experience.
See, it's pretty wet on that bottom side. Uh-huh. Está poco mojado aquí. ¿No? Sí, sí, más fresco.
Okay, so we've got a small female lion going down the creek here. We found some lion scat here. And then a little fresher than that we found earlier this morning in another canyon. So things are picking up a little bit. We'll probably snare this canyon, although it'd be a long walk in here. I think we ought to try to catch this lion.
Maybe a real good snare site right there. Pretty cool mountain.
Everything's gonna funnel through that thing.
Yeah, no, it's a good place. I think that line we've seen the tracks of came down through here. Yeah, I think so.
Once a favorable location has been established, the field team sets the traps. Then a waiting game begins that can go on for weeks. During the field season, there may be up to half a dozen such sites, and each one must be checked on a daily basis.
Little Yankee ingenuity there.
That's the game?
Yeah, that one. Looks pretty good, Luis.
Pretty good set for a little old canyon.
By 1995, there were 10 mountain lions that had been trapped, collared with a radio transmitter, released, and monitored on the Big Bend Ranch. Approximately every 2 weeks, members of the team fly over the ranch and collect radio telemetry on the cats. From this data, the ranges and territories of these mountain lions have been mapped. The lions are recaptured every 24 to 26 months, so they can be fitted with new collars with fresh batteries. Today, the dogs will be used to help track a cat that is scheduled for recollaring.
Dogs is a complete different means of capture. It's a very good means of live capture. It's a little more difficult in open desert country because you don't have the trees like you do in other areas. And so it requires a little more manpower. And it's a very exciting method of capture, but it's also very safe if you've got the experience in it.
Once the mountain lion has been located by the personnel in the air, the chase on the ground begins. Oh,
How far is that line from that corner if we can't get through it and we have to walk?
Be careful, come on, I gotta have some help on these kittens. Are you with me? Vente. Come on. Fixing to go here, come on. Come on, hey, hey, shh, come here. Oh, come here. Get him, Riley. Come on, Riley.
Expecting to find only one cat, the field crew was surprised to find a mother and a number of kittens. The mother escaped, but one of the kittens was captured.
Well, you really hit a family here. It's good luck. But you guys did a heck of a job getting over here. It's a tough deal. I'm glad you did what you needed to do.
I think the future in Texas is fairly bright for the mountain lion, as long as things stay more or less like they are right now. The private landowners that have cattle seem to be able to live with the mountain lion all right. It's usually where mountain lion and sheep and goats come into contact with each other, where you really have a conflict. Right now in West Texas, there's not many sheep and goats, so in West Texas, the population is stable and even increasing in some places.
Got to wait till it goes out a little bit more and then try to put the collar on it, and then I'll take measurements. And then we'll give it a reversal and a little bit of penicillin. And I put her back in this hole and hopefully Mama come back for her.
I hope that we always have lions in Texas. But I also, you know, understand why people have to protect their property. So it's a give and take situation right now for mountain lions, and it probably will be that for quite some time.
The knowledge gained by this study, and others like it, will play a crucial role in deciding the future of the mountain lions. Today in Texas, these cats remain unprotected by law. By increasing our understanding of these predators, we can hopefully ensure they will continue to thrive as living reminders of our natural heritage.